Isso, pode
It's the craft. My name is Kira.
Hi, I'm Kira.
Hey, I'm Annie.
Hello, I'm Saskia.
Sup, my name's Clara.
Hi, I'm Flora.
Hi, I'm John.
Yo, it's Molly.
Hi, I'm Sarah. And we are the students from School of Maragon Small. And this is our video for the Young Environment.
And we are the
We are the Bottom Wildlife Wanderers!
Very good, guys. Okay, guys, say hello and wave. You're on video.
I'm done.
Here we go. Okay, off to the park.
By the river in January, but there'll soon be lots of wildlife in here. Can you tell us what might be here soon?
Soon there will be frog spawn in these rivers. It's a frog spawn turned to a turned to frog.
And what do frogs do? Thanks, lad.
Very good.
Okay, we're gonna get a picture of you there, guys. So you wanna join them?
Today, looking at birds, and Kira's seen some birds today. What type of birds did you see today?
I've seen a robin, magpies, chaffinch,
and blackbirds. That's good. Lots of birds in the park. Let's the birds. You'll get lost by this.
In Ballymote Castle and the church. Bats are useful as they eat tiny insects like midges. The Irish name for bat is Ilcog. Here's an example of echolocation.
I think we can locate you through that echo.
Lots of hedgehogs in Ballymote. Unfortunately, most of the hedgehogs we find will be dead ones in the road, and I know Saskia's got a little story to tell us about that.
Well, up here in Castlegrove is up there, and when my granny used to live up there, my mum and my sister went up before and they saw a dead hedgehog on the road.
No.
Tell us your thing.
Now?
Yeah.
Here's our sign of butterflies and moths.
There are lots of different coloured butterflies and over 300 types of moths have been found in Ballymote.
Even though it's winter, you can see butterflies.
Two wildlife experts in Ballymote, and they're going to have a little discussion right now.
What's the difference between a weasel and a stoat?
One's weaselly recognisable and one's stoatly different.
Recording, guys.
So Sarah.
Here you go.
Okay. Okay, be careful, guys. Be friendly.
To say that we found an injured dolphin.
We see collared dogs at the school and we found an injured one.
There was before a nest in the tree and we think it was a blackbird that made it and there was a blue egg in it, but it broke.
Where was it?
Right there.
Oh, what did you do with the dove?
I think we got Molly's dad.
Yeah? What did he do?
We got Molly's dad and he took it over downtown and went to a vet.
Cool. Well done, Michael.
Ballymote, like so many parts of this beautiful island of Ireland that we share, is an area of outstanding natural beauty and has a huge variety of fascinating wildlife. Our project has given us a great insight into the animals we share our town with and the relationships that we have with them. We found out about foxes, hedgehogs, bats, rabbits, hares and birds, to name a few, and we found out a little bit about how to protect our shared environment and why it is so important. We have displayed this in our information stand, which we will leave on display at the library. We invite people from the town to use our information stand as an area to display their own information about the Ballymote environment, photographs of animals, stories or other information that can help raise awareness of the issues we need to take action on.
We want to include everyone in this way because we would like this to be a community project. We are determined to continue to improve the environment for ourselves and the wildlife we share it with. So, we invite you to help us by putting up bird boxes, keeping the area clean, and being on the lookout for ways to help. We hope you enjoyed our video and that you will be inspired to learn more about the small ways each of us can look after our beautiful Ballymote environment and all those who live here, be they furry, feathered, winged, or human.